Sections 11.1 through 11.3 address techniques of counting. We'll answer questions like, how many five-digit zip codes can be formed? In how many orders can 10 people line up? How many five-card hands can be dealt from a deck? The answer to the card hands question is about 2.6 million, so we can't just count them all one at a time. We need techniques. All the techniques we learn are based on the fundamental counting principle. The diagram on page 688 of your textbook illustrates the principle. To create an outfit by matching one of two pairs of pants with one of three shirts, we can match each pair of pants with any of the three shirts. So there are 2 times 3, or 6, ways to do this. We multiplied. So if we have two sets with a certain number of items in each, M in set A and N in set B, the number of ways to combine one item each from set A and set B is found by multiplying. M times N. Example 1. A pizza can be ordered with 3 choices of size, and they list them, 4 choices of crust, and they list them, and 6 choices of toppings. How many one-topping pizzas can be ordered? Much like the pants and shirts example, we're choosing one item from each of the groupings, so we just need to multiply the number of choices from each grouping. 3 sizes times 4 crust choices times 6 toppings equals 72. Example 2. A California driver's license number consists of a letter followed by 7 digits. How many license numbers can be formed? For license numbers, passwords, codes, etc., I like to use a fill-in-the-blanks method. Put a blank for each of the spaces that will be filled in to create the license number. So, 1 space for the letter, and 7 spaces for the digits. Letter. And digits. In each space, write the number of choices we have. There are 26 letters, 10 digits in each of these spaces. Since there's 26 letters in the alphabet and the 10 digits represent 0 through 9, so multiply those all together and we get 260 million. Example 3. A password to log onto a computer account is to consist of 3 letters followed by 3 digits. Determine the number of possible passwords if the first letter must be an A or a B, and the first digit must be a 1, 2, or 3. We'll still use fill in the blanks, but now we have some restrictions. Three letters, and 3 numbers, blanks for 3 numbers, or digits. Since the first letter must be an A or B, we only have 2 choices for the first blank. The first digit must be a 1, 2, or 3, so there are 3 choices. There are no restrictions mentioned for the other spaces, So we use the usual 26 for letters. And 10 for digits. Multiply. And the answer is 405,600. For part B, same situation, so use the same blanks as part A. This time, none of the letters can be a Q or Z. 26 letters minus the two that are excluded leaves 24 letters available for the blanks, for the letters. The first digit must be a 1, 2, or 3, so there are three choices there. The last digit cannot be a 7, so that leaves 9 digits available, 10 minus the one that's excluded. The problem doesn't give any restrictions for the middle digit, so we have the usual 10 there. Multiply, and we get 3,732,480.